Hey, people! What is up? Well, if you've watched my videos in the past, then you might know that I'm a big fan of folding knives. But I also carry fixed blades for self-defense. And whenever it comes to fixed blades, my preference is generally the tactical knives. Or Tacti-cool. That's right, y'all. I like something like the cold steel. Steel Tiger. Or the cold steel Kaboom. You know, I like just a nice, lightweight, synthetic, kind of a work knife, you know, something that you wouldn't mind thumping on. I'm not really crazy about the ornate or the heavier, you know, just real big flashy knives, you know. I like something that's tactical. You know, that's just what I prefer as far as fixed blades go. Something like, maybe, I don't know, this Glock knife right here. You know, it's got a good synthetic sheath, synthetic handle. Just a good knife, you know, coated. You can thump on it. And you ain't gonna worry about scratching up the blade because it just makes it, you know, look pretty whenever you scratch it up. You know, it makes it look all used, and that's the way a tactical knife should do, you know. So, you know, as far as my fixed blade preferences, I generally go for something that's like this, or like the cold steels I've shown, you know. But, you know, they're just a work knife, and I like using my knives, but I do like collecting, you know, I like collecting knives that are fancy, too. Sometimes, but you know, this is one of my favorite fixed blades right here. So I really do love my Glock field knife. I think it's a great knife for all kinds of things, including but not limited to putting out small fires that pop up in your house in the middle of the night. But inevitably, I have to ask myself, what would Crocodile Dundee say about this knife if I were to pull it out and show him? Well, I think he might say something like this. That's not a knife. This is a knife. Yep, I think it would probably go something like that. If you look at him here, that's a healthy blade, y'all. So I'm going to talk about it. Now, real quick, what this is, for those of you that don't know, is the Linder Big Western. That's right, y'all. It's the Big Western. That big is an understatement. This is a monster mofo right here, y'all. And I got this knife back when I was probably about 10 or 11 years old. My dad got me this one. I think he paid around $200 for it, something like that. This is a gift that he got me. He used to always buy me some kick-ass knives, and I'm going to tell y'all about it. I mean, first of all, I've had this knife forever. I've used it, actually. You can see on the blade there. Got some use on it. Some of that's fingerprints and smudges. Some of it's actually scratching, but it's still pretty damn sharp. It dulled out a little bit over time because I've used it, but this knife right here is not my ideal knife these days. You know, I prefer something a little bit more tactical. That's right, y'all. I prefer something with a little bit more black on it. But you know what? These right here are beautiful. You know I'm a country boy. Well, I grew up in a city, but I'm still a country boy. And, or, you know, some people call me a redneck or a hillbilly or white trash or whatever. But thing about it is, this is not my preferred style, but it is beautiful. I do have a place in my heart for them. It's got that beautiful stag handle, that bone handle, whatever. It's just real gorgeous. Gives you some traction too, actually. But this thing weighs a ton, man. I don't have a scale here to measure the weight, but this thing is just, it's like three or four of those Glock knives, you know. And it's got the saw spine up here. You know, you can actually saw some pretty good tree sizes with that. I've actually done it, you know. You can see there it's been used, but I'm not 100% on steel. I bet you it's a 440 though. I think Linder used to use a lot of 440 back in the day, and I have no reason to believe this is different, you know. A lot of their other knives used a 440. I believe at some point they used a 690 or something like that, but I don't know a whole lot about this company, to be honest with you. But you can see right there, it is a Linder. It's the Big Western. Got you a leather sheath. You know, I'm not the greatest fan of leather sheaths either. I think they're beautiful. I think they're cool as hell for like a showpiece. But as far as being tactical, I don't think they're the best option. But you can see it is a nice looking sheath. And it's built real well because this thing has held up throughout the years. And I've actually carried it. I've actually carried this knife around with me. Not open it in public and shit like that. That wouldn't be cool. But I think this well exceeds the 5.5 limit. What do y'all think? Here in Texas, this is a little bit too big, I think. But, you know, beautiful knife. Got your little blood groove right there. Your high polish, which, you know, I'm not a real big high polish guy either, you know. But there is something to be said for the beauty of that. You got your little unsharpened swedge up here. Got your Bowie style. What's not to love about the good old Bowie knife? Or Bowie knife, depending on what regions you hail from. Got your little tang right here with the balls on it, which actually hurt like a mofo. Ask me how I know. Okay, I know somebody's going to ask me, so I'll tell you how I know. I actually dropped this damn thing on my foot. Not the blade, thank God, because that would have took my foot off. As much as this thing weighs, my foot would have been in like half. But I dropped it, and this ball slammed into my big toe, and man, that damn thing hurts. So you could actually probably, you know, hit somebody in the forehead with that. Does a good job of keeping you from going forward if you were to stab this through somebody's, I don't know, eye. How about that? Right through the eye, y'all. You know, the handle feels good. Got some good traction with that. Those deep cuts in the bone there. See that? And I love the natural look of that. I love how they're all, you know, there's no two bone handles alike because they're all like, you know, hand done and all that. Got the stacked leather, little rings right there. Got your little pommel back here, which I believe is a stainless. And then you got your little brass screw that you tighten this up and it tightens it down on there. It's got like a full tang type of thing going on in there. Just a cool knife, y'all. Cool knife. Damn good knife to have in a collection. Would I use it? Not these days. I've actually used it in the past, you know, when I first got it and stuff, and I just thought it was the coolest damn thing ever. I used to pull this out for my friends whenever I was in middle school. Not in middle school. I didn't take it to middle school with me, y'all. I know you're thinking exacto probably did, but no, I didn't. I didn't take this to school, but whenever my friends would come over to the house, I'd pull this out, and I'd be like, that's not a knife. This is a knife. You know, they had their little Swiss Army knives and all that stuff, and I pulled this mofo out. Yeah. That's how I rolled, y'all. But, you know, nowadays, I'd probably want to use something like this. This is super lightweight. Better sheath for, you know, in my opinion, for, like, you know, outdoors use. You know, and you've got a lot of options. You can mount it and, you know, quick release. And, you know, I just like the weight of it and the, you know, it's just a good field knife. I wouldn't want to go beat up on something like this, although you do see I did use it. But nowadays, if I were to get this nowadays, I would probably keep it, you know, pristine. But being young and getting this big old knife, I had to go play with it, you know? And that's okay. Gives it a little character. I don't plan on ever selling it because it's sentimental to me. My daddy got me this, and he loves it more than I do. He's always asking about this one. He's like, hey, man, let me check out that Big Western. I had this over my mom's house. That's why I haven't showed y'all yet. I had this over my mom's house for a long time, and I just never really, you know, got it back. I just left it over there in my storage, you know, my stuff, my important stuff. Got a lot of cool knives over there I need to bring over and show y'all from my childhood. But yeah, this is the Linder Big Western. A good knife if you live in Texas. Anyway, I just thought I'd show y'all. I never got a chance to show y'all that. Probably a 440, like I said. You know, just a cool, cool knife. And one thing about these big old Bowie styles, Man, I tell you, if you were to hit somebody with that thing like that, you know, just like give them a little love tap in the head with it, in the forehead, it's going to crack them open. This thing, the weight on it is just ridiculous. This would be a hell of a fighting knife. I mean, you pull this bad boy out right here, I mean, whew. Anybody want to go against this thing? Hell. You know, they got some damn problems. Because it sure is something. I mean, if you look at it up against, like, you know, my little Kobun here, which I think is a great self-defense type knife. Man, this right here, you know, it'd be a heavy one to carry, but if you did, look at all that blade, man. Ooh, that's something else. So, this would be a damn good fighting knife, which, to my understanding, is what the Bowie knife was designed for in the first place. Kind of a small sword, if you will, you know, for fighting and just an all-around knife, really. You know, it's just a great piece of our history, and you know, it's been around for a while, and hey man, it's still cool as hell. You got some tactical style, but wait a minute. You got some tactical style Bowie knives out there. Cole still does a few, and there's some other brands out there and stuff, but you know, man, these good old, you know, flashy, heavy, ornate Bowie knives are just, you know, they got a place right in my heart, y'all, and this one right here especially. So I thought I would show it to you. I'm just pretty much rambling about it. I don't know. I don't know a whole lot about the Bowie history or nothing. I know a little bit, but you know, I'm just basically showing it off to y'all, letting y'all see it. You imagine this thing right here, somebody pulls this out. If I had, man, I love my Steel Tiger, but if I pulled my Steel Tiger out, and I was like, come on, motherfucker, come on then, come get some, you feel froggy? Then leap, motherfucker. You know, if I did something like that, no, I wouldn't do that, y'all. I'd probably not say a damn thing. They wouldn't even know I had the knife till it was too late. But if I did do that, and they pulled out something like this, this is a knife, and they did that, then I just throw my fucking, you know, karambit down and run. Because this right here is formidable. Matter of fact, if I had my Glock, maybe I had my Glock 40, and they pulled this out, I'm gonna be like, oh shit. This damn thing can stop bullets. You just put it up in front of you. Ping, ping, ping. You know, just blow them bullets on back to you. But, oh God, y'all, I'm feeling crazy. I'm going to get out of here before I start just completely going off the damn charts with rambling. But that is my Big Western Bowie by Linder. A piece of my history. A piece of our nation's history. And, this video is a piece of history, so let's get out of here, y'all. Life's short. Stay sharp.